Hello and welcome back to Roochis Town. Today we have a cooking video and I would like to take you along with me to get some vegetables for some of our dishes. Come, let's get going. We are at our vegetable garden. So if you have seen some of my videos, you know that we grow our vegetables during the season, and we have planted radish and turnip, and they are all grown. So they would be medium sized, but I would like to harvest it today and use it for our cooking. So come, let's get going. So here's a small radish. Keep it here. There it is. It's grown nicely. These are not the very lengthy type of radish. These are the small ones. The variety itself is small. These are quite little, but one. Yes, look at this. It's all grown. This is good. And one last. Again, here it is. This is also small, but we are good. So, this should be enough for today's cooking. Apart from this, I have sown few other seeds which are sprouting. These are the cucumber. Here we have tomatoes, and we have some chili seeds that we have planted, and we have some brinjal and beans. Actually, these are all really new that we have planted, so it will take about a couple of weeks before they are ready grow and harvest. And I have some methi seeds. Actually, this is just like a week ago that I sowed them, and they've all sprouted, and it's about half an inch. So let's take this and start our cooking. So I'll put this and start cleaning them before I take it inside. There's a lot of mud here. Some weed and all. It's a feel good tractor, growing our own vegetables and eating them. We haven't sprayed anything on these, no chemicals, naturally grown, organic. Even the manure was something that we made it ourselves at home. So there we can see that we put all our kitchen waste. We have composted them. We put them all together. And here it is. So I'm going to use both of these for different dishes. So with this radish, I'm going to make some sambar, and with the greens, I'm going to make some kind of a fry. Let's see how we're going to do it. So I'm going to clean this once again, cut them and clean them, and I'll show you how it looks like. Okay. here we have our produce, the radish and the greens from the radish. So we're going to make sambar out of this and stir fry out of this. I'm able to add some chickpeas also along with this. Let me show you. Removed all the stems and I've cleaned it well, and we will start chopping this finely. So we have a radish cut into round pieces and they are ready, and the greens have been chopped finely. And let's look at the ingredients that we would need for this. So this side what we have is a chickpea, dry red chilies, some turmeric, cumin seeds, urad dal, chili powder, and this is asafoetida hing, and some garlic. And for the sambar we have onions, tomatoes, green chilies, and coriander leaves for garnishing. I have boiled a cup of tuvar dal and kept it ready. There is a pinch of hing in it, and I have soaked and taken out the juice from the tamarind. And also this onions that we have, a lot of onions, is for the stir fry. So let's start cooking. I'll take this. Turn the stove on medium high, and I have to crush this garlic to put it into the greens. Don't chop it, chopping will not taste good, so the juices and all will come out well, and a lot of garlic also is good, but I've taken about 5 to 6 pods here. This. So the oil is heated. I'm going to add cumin seeds. The urad dal. Urad dal has to turn a little golden. So basically this is for the stir fry. Okay, and I've added hing and some dry red chilies, and we'll add the turmeric. So as soon as this is done, we'll add the onions. Onion is frying. I'm going to add the crushed garlic into this. So let's add some salt. The onions are almost done. I'm going to add the greens, radish greens, homegrown radish greens. So the greens are still frying. So I have a cooked a cup of chickpeas here. I had soaked them overnight, and I have used a pressure cooker and cooked it, or you can even get canned chickpeas. Mix it. And I have some red chilies, homemade red chilies. You can skip this because I have already put red chilies also, whole red chilies. You can skip this if you don't want, but that will not give much taste, so that's why I have added this. You can adjust it according to your taste. Let it fry. We will close the lid and fry it for about 5 to 7 minutes. So let it fry for 5 to 7 minutes in medium fry. Put the greens into the other stove, and I've heated a pan and added some oil. I put sunflower oil into it and not olive oil, because for especially for the sambar I prefer sunflower oil. So let's start with the radish sambar. I have oil which is being heated. I'm going to add some green chilies and onions. I'm going to add the tomatoes also together. I don't want all of them to be fried separately. Just briefly, I'm going to fry this. I will start adding even the radish now. We'll add some salt. So the radish and onions, tomatoes are frying for a few minutes. So we'll go ahead and add the cooked dal into this. And I'm going to add a glass of water. We'll mix this well. And we need some more spice, so I'm going to add a spoon of homemade chili powder. We'll close the lid and let this cook for a couple of minutes till the radish is tender and soft. So once that is done, we are going to add our tamarind pulp that we have taken, and season it and finish it off. Now let's check how our greens are. So I have been stirring it a couple of times in between. They look almost done. So I'm going to check the taste and I will put it into a serving bowl. We have our homegrown radish sambar and radish greens, chickpeas, stir fry. So I have some rice here in the plate and I'm gonna try both these recipes. It's a whole meal, so let's add some pickle to it. I have some homemade mango pickle. I will post the recipes for this in my future videos. So let's check out the sambar. See, you can see this radish is nice and tender. It's cooked so well. You feel so happy actually to eat something that you have grown at home, which is organic, no chemicals, and something that you've watered every day, and there it is in a plate right from the garden into your kitchen and on the plate, not frozen, not refrigerated, directly from the home garden. Nice. It's really very good. Let's try these greens out. Properly spiced There's no difference. I can really not find out that it's a radish green. It just tastes like palak or spinach. You can mix this with rice. When you're mixing this with rice, you can add some oil and eat. That will give a great heavenly taste. Try out these recipes, and if you like it, like this video, like, share and subscribe to Roochis. Thank you.